What are we going into?
The temple of the Most High. The temple of the Most High. You know, a hot topic. The t-shirt of the week, in the words of Apostle Cabal. You know, the flavor is taking care of your vessel, you know. Taking care of the Most High's vessel. The Spirit hit me watching Apostle Cabal's epistles and how he's motivating and exhorting brothers to get more into walking, being more active, just overall activity, right? Because we're alive. We're not dead. The dead sleep. The alive is supposed to move. So he's exhorting brothers to get more active, you know, take walks, go to the forest, go to the woods, go to the trails, go to the beach. Just get outside, man. Get in nature. Because it do something to the spirit. It do something to the flesh, to your senses. And it relieves you, it opens you up, like the breath of fresh air. But you know, the Spirit hit me like a ton of bricks. You know, the Most High handed me my assignment. And what came to mind was, how are you treating the vehicle of the Most High? The Most High loaned you his vehicle. And how are you treating that vehicle? The Most High gave you the keys to his house. How are you treating the Most High's house? So there's layers to this. And you can go in any direction. The house of the Most High, the car of the Most High, the abode of the Most High, which is your house, your vessel. So let's get into it. Lock in. First and foremost, I'm going to start off by giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Wahab, Rakab, Kadash, the honest of my apostles, and elders at Great Millstone, the men that told me this truth through spirit. Peace and blessings to the elect of the house of Israel that scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. How are you treating the vessel of the Most High? This is something you got to ask yourself. And this is a daily thing. Matter of fact, sidebars, in the words of Apostle Tahar, there's subjects within subjects, you know? This is the book of Luke, chapter 9, verse 23. And he said to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. So this is a daily activity, right? This is a daily thing. You have to take up your cross. What is taking up your cross? Taking up your faith in this truth, right? Taking time from yourself and giving it to the Lord. That's taking up your cross. This mission, this objective to serve the Lord, this is your cross, right? It says, if any man come after me, so if you're going after Yahweh Shah, you seek it after Yahweh Shah, deny himself, right? Once again, how are you treating the vessel of the Lord? Are you denying yourself, right? Because remember, the flesh craves. It just craves and craves and craves. Are you supposed to give in to your flesh? Are you supposed to give in to your senses? Right? Or are you supposed to fight against your senses or fight against the flesh? Right? So it says, and deny himself. Let's look up this word deny. Because this all ties into, how are you treating the vessel of the Most High? It says, deny, the state that one refuses to admit the truth or existence of. It says refuse to give or grant something, request or desire to someone. So you have to refuse yourself. You have to stop yourself. And that all goes into the category of being patient. That all goes into the category of being long-suffering. And what are those true attributes? Fruits of the Spirit. All right? So it says, and take up his cross daily, which is this mission, faith and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, but whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall save the same shall save it. Now going back to how are you treating the vessel of the Lord? This is 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19. What? Know ye not that the body is the temple of the Holy Spirit? Right? So your body, which is the abode, which is the house of the Lord. Because the Lord doesn't make, he doesn't dwell in temples made with hands. He doesn't dwell in buildings. He doesn't dwell in synagogues, temples, mosques. All right? He dwells in the Israelite man's body. So it says, know ye not that the body is the temple of the Most High, which is in you, which ye have of the Most High, and ye are not of your own. So how are you treating the vessel of the Most High? Are you feeding it with a whole bunch of sugar, salt, chips, cookies, cakes, soda, fast food? Is that what you giving the vessel of the Most High? The vessel that the Most High loaned you, right? This is why you gotta check yourself. And once again, the Spirit speaks through us to us. So this applies to me 10 times more that is coming from you, right? I get cut when I speak because it's the Spirit of the Lord that speaks through me, right? So it says, and ye are not of your own. So once again, the Most High loaned you this vessel, right? For the time period that you're on earth. How are you supposed to treat that vessel? Right? No, now knowing that your body is loaned by the Most High, how are you going to treat that vessel? Get active, man. Get active. Start moving. Get the hell off the chair and the couch and the bed, man. Get out your house. Get active. And I don't want to hear you an introvert, because the majority of brothers are introverts. The majority of brothers don't like people, right? That's the majority, that's all, you know, that's the majority of the service of the Lord. But that has nothing to do with you moving and you being active and working out, right? So it says, what? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Most High? Oh, I read that. No? Yep. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, which is in you, which ye have of the Most High, and ye are not of you. Not your own, for ye are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify the Most High in your body. You're supposed to glorify the Lord in your body, man. All right, how do you do that? By putting your body as a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable, which is your reasonable service. And not only sacrificing your body, right? You got to do right by your body. You got to do right with your temple, man. Keep it clean. Right? Not just because, or as Apostle Paul just said, just because you keep the dietary laws doesn't mean you keeping it that is unhealthy kosher things. There's kosher unhealthy foods. Or you can have a bad kosher diet or a habit. All right? So just because you keep the dietary laws doesn't mean you're keeping it healthy, right? So it says, for ye are bought with a price, which is the blood that Yahweh Shah had to give when he sacrificed his life. Therefore, glorify the Most High in your body. And you got to take care of yourself. You got to. Because you can't glorify the Most High when you're sick. Because then you're crying unto the Lord to help you and to save you. You can't glorify the Most High being sick, man. You can't glorify the Most High when you on your deathbed. You gotta glorify the Most High in your youth, when you're young, when you feeling good, and when you're doing this work, man.
My nigga, you could do it too.
Which is pretty decent, especially for my age. But that comes from the walking. That's why I tell you brothers and sisters out there, if you want to get your blood pressure down, you want to get your blood sugar down, you got to do your walking every day. Okay? It has to become a focal part of your life. Okay? again, the scripture says bodily exercise profiteth little, but it does profit. Okay, exercise is very much a part of our life as diet is. The two go hand in hand. Okay, for your diet to really work, you have to exercise. For your exercise to really work, you have to watch your diet. You have to watch what you eat, especially when you get older, you know. When you get up in age, you can't eat you can't eat the crap that you could when you was 20, in your 20s, early 20s. You know, you can't eat that stuff when you get up in your past, you know, your 40s and whatnot. Okay, you can't eat that stuff, man. That stuff will kill you, man. You know, don't wait to go to the doctor and then the doctor has to do it for you. You know, we really should become our own physician, not even doctor, because the word doctor is from the Latin, which means to falsify. We should become our own physician. You know, we should learn about the herbs. We should learn about taking care of our own health. Nobody's going to care more about your health than you. I don't care what your so-called doctor says, all right? He's got other people he tends to. You know, and at the end of the day, it's all about profit with them. You know what I mean about profit. Okay, you gotta, you brothers and sisters out there, which primarily speaking to you, brothers and sisters of this household of faith, particularly GMS and our true affiliates, you gotta care about your own health.